The second presentation is on locally advanced cervical cancers, nomograms predicting the overall survival in locally advanced cervical cancer who were treated with image-guided brachytherapy. It was a retro-embrace study. So the background is that locally advanced cervical cancer, the outcomes are dependent on the disease itself, on the treatment factors that the patient receives, as well as the patient factors. And though we do have nomograms that predict the survival for locally advanced cervical cancer, but then we don't have anyone in the era of image-guided adaptive brachytherapy. So the objective here was to present a nomogram for prediction of overall survival in locally advanced cervical cancers for patients undergoing chemoradiation, including image-guided adaptive brachytherapy. 720 patients of any histology, squamous, adeno, or adenosquamous, were treated with radical chemoradiation, including image-guided adaptive brachytherapy, and followed up for 56 months. There were 13 candidate predictors that were decided to predict the overall survival, the factors being age, hemoglobin, histology, the FIGO stage, the tumor width, corpus involvement, presence of hydronephrosis, parametral involvement, the lymph node status, receiving concurrent chemotherapy along with treatment or not, overall treatment time, and the response to radiochemotherapy in the form of the high-risk CTV volume at first brachytherapy fraction and the HR-CTV D90. So a multivariable Cox model was formed for overall survival, and a stepwise selection with the AIC criteria was used to construct a nomogram. So these were the factors that were analyzed, and 10 factors came out to be statistically significant on univariate analysis. Presence of hydronephrosis, parametral involvement, and histology did not come out to be significant. On multivariate analysis, 4 of these came out to be significant. They were the FIGO stage, the presence of lymph nodes, concurrent chemotherapy, and the high-risk CTV volume at first brachytherapy fraction. Taking the AIC predictive model, 7 factors were selected for use in the nomograms. And this was the point system that was given to compute the nomogram. So the FIGO stage 2B, 3A to 4B, 0.0 to 1. The fraction 1 HRCTV volume in CC, 0 to 160 CC, points from 0 to 100. Corpus involvement, 0 to 1. Concurrent chemo, yes, no, 1 or 0, overall treatment time, age at diagnosis. So we can see that the younger age is having a worse prognosis. Lymph node involvement, the total points, and this finally was the 60-month overall survival probability. So this was a unique part of this paper, that the fraction 1 HRCTV volume was a new factor that was taken into account to compute these nomograms. And what was found was on this graph, on x-axis, you can see the predicted survival probability. And on the y-axis is the observed survival probability. So there was a good concordance of 0.74 at 5 years. So what was concluded from this paper was, this is the first nomogram to predict overall survival in locally advanced cervical cancer patients treated with image-guided adaptive brachytherapy. Previously reported factors like age, FIGO stage, overall treatment time, chemotherapy delivery were reconfirmed as important outcome predictors, and response to radiochemotherapy in the form of the HRCTV at first brachytherapy fraction was a new essential outcome predictor. And further validation of this nomogram is being performed and will be presented when the EMBRACE data matures. So the take-home message is, overall survival can be predicted based on patient risk factors, and it can help clinicians to tailor their therapy better, to counsel their patients as to the risk of recurrence and the outcome of disease. Thank you.